Why don't we start from the beginning? When did you get into dogs, and what made you get into dogs?
Well, I wanted a pit bull ever since I was a kid. You know, I'd read about them, and my parents wouldn't let me get one. You know, I had to get other breeds, and then when I got out of the Army, it dawned on me I could get any kind of dog I wanted, but I didn't, you know, they acted, all the books I was reading, they acted like the pit bulls was sort of not around anymore. So I got a Staffordshire Terrier, you know, which was supposed to be the closest thing. And then I found out that there were pit bulls, that they were still around. And so I sold the staff and I got a pit bull from a guy named Adolf Torres. It was a pretty good pit bull. And that was my first a pit bull. That was, I was just out of the Army. I was 23. And I bought that pit bull, and then later on, not too long after that, I met a guy named Arnie Steinberg, and he showed me around and taught me a lot of stuff, and a friend, a guy that he knew, Keith Allen, was getting out of dogs. And he had a bitch and a male, and they were bred together, so the bitch had a litter inside her. And he got me a real good deal on that. I just had to give him half of the pups when they were born. So they were really good dogs. So I got lucky. I got some really good dogs right off the bat. The first one I got from a guy named Adolf Torres. She was a good bitch. She wasn't of the quality of the other ones that I got, but she was a nice bitch. I had a lot of fun with her. It wasn't too long till I had the dogs' names were Tater and Faith, and they were Klaus bred and Richardson bred, and they were both dead game dogs, Tater and Faith, the puppies were real good. I gave Arnie his half. It was a big litter, and so he got five, and I got five. But I should have kept all of my five, but I sold a few and just kept a few. And then I tried, later on, I realized how good they were. I went to the people to try and buy them back, but they, you know, they were in love with the dog. It was their family pet, so I had to forget that idea. But anyway, that's when I got started. First pit bull was her name was Loka, and then a few months after that, after I met Arnie Steinberg and he got me in on that deal, then I had Tater and Face and some of the pups from them, and those were my first real quality dogs.
Now, what were your favorite bloodlines through the years?
Well, my favorite blood is Oleo. He was the best dog and the best producing dog. I had lots of good lines that I liked, but Oleo was my favorite of everything. And then the first original dogs I got were very good. They were as good as anything, and then I got dogs from Don Maloney and his bloodline. They were very good. So those were the three main lines: the Tater Face stuff. The Tater Face stuff is heavy in Bert Klaus's blood, and it's heavy in some Ed Rich stuff, which is sort of like Diablo stuff. And then the face bitch, they were half brother and sister, Tater and Faith. They both had heavy Klaus on the one side, so they They were solid. That was a really solid line. And then the dogs I got from Don Maloney, boy, his bred were very good. But Bender was the best of all, you know, and I crossed him over those dogs. You know, over. The reason I got Tombstone is I was at a place drinking coffee with some guys that, you know, that didn't usually agree on much of anything. And the only thing they agree on was Bert Sorrells and Indian Sonny and a few other guys. And they all agreed that this dog, Tombstone, was the best dog. So later on, I went on a trip, and I went to Mayfield's place. And the Tombstone dog, he offered him for sale, and I remember what those guys said, so I bought him. And then after I got him, all of a sudden, they said he wasn't so good anymore. Familiarity, you know, somebody having the dog right there. As long as he was in Texas, he was the greatest. But when a local dog man brought him into California, then all of a sudden, he wasn't so good. But he was good. And Don Maloney made a trip to my house. I wasn't expecting it, but he made a trip to my house, and he wanted to breed Tombstone. You know, Maloney bred Tombstone in the first place, and then so that's how I got more deeper into the Maloney blood. Was already had the Tombstone dog, and then Maloney brought out a bitch and bred the Tombstone. I got pups out of that, and then I purchased a bitch from him, and so I started. I got into the Maloney dogs, and they were real good dogs. They were real good dogs, and so they all mixed in together real good too. I had the Tater Faith dogs, the Maloney type dogs, but Belio was. He was just the best of all of them as far as a dog himself and as far as what he could produce. He was my favorite. But I needed the other lines of dogs, you know. They were all good. Mm-hmm. I'd like to get the dogs that carry a lot of my blood. I prefer that, but I may just have to settle for good pit bulls. I want a few pit bulls. I don't want a whole big yard of them. I just want one or two good ones. I'll probably end up getting one or two from Lee because he's a good guy and I trust him, and he'll make me a reasonable price, and the dog will be something that that he wants. So there's probably other guys I could get a good dog from. I just don't know who they are or what, you know.
Right.
I don't know any of these new dog men or anything.
Who are your favorite dog men to work with over the years?
Pretty much, I'm trying to think. But that Arnie Steinberg guy, he taught me a lot. And he helped me, but then later on he did some stuff I didn't like, so I ended up not being friends with him anymore. You know, but I learned a lot from him. You know, he taught me a lot. I had a few customers that I had a good relationship with. I was pretty much on my own. You know, I didn't have a partner or anything. Just Emily I had customers that I had a good relationship with, you know, a guy named Darren Steele. He was a nice guy. I did some breedings with him. And most of them, to tell you the truth, most of them weren't very good people, the guys and the dogs. You know, they just weren't. They didn't do the dogs right, and they didn't treat people right. So I was mainly on my own, and my best relationships were probably with customers of mine. Mm-hmm. I didn't have any guy that I worked hand in hand with or anything like that, you know.
Right.
I sold a good dog to Ralph Greenwood because I was sort of in awe of him, And then it turns out he sold the dog to another guy named Carl Wynn. And instead of giving me first chance to get the dog back, because I really loved that dog. The only reason I sold it to Greenwood, I was too much in awe of him. I should have just said, no, she's not for sale, and I should have kept him. But it ended up, he gave the dog and sold it to this guy, Carl Wynn. Not trust people too much, because 9 times out of 10, they'll let you down. And if you have a favorite dog, don't let anybody else have it. Just that's one of my biggest regrets to this day, is some of the good dogs that I turned loose for one reason or another, that and I knew they were good, and I should have hung on to them. And you know, it's not right for the dogs either, because the people I sold them to, they didn't do them right. You know, they didn't treat them right. And so for the dog's sake and my sake, I should have kept my very favorites. Like I say, you got to sell quality, and I did. You know, I had a good product. I put up good dogs, and I sold good dogs for top dollar. You got to do that, or people won't come back and buy anymore. But when you have a favorite, hang on to it. Yeah, just hang on to it.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, let me ask you this, because over the years, there's been huge debate about this. Do pit bull terriers, have you ever seen a pit bull terrier come in blue?
No, I never saw those. In all the years I was in the dogs, I never saw a blue pit bull, not once. I think they're a new thing. I think maybe the Neo Mastiffs or something. Something was crashed in there, because it's not one of the normal colors. You know, I've seen black and tans, reds, whites, red and whites, blacks, lots of different colors, but not blue. And like I said, I was in the dogs from 1968. Until 2008, so that's 40 years, and I never seen a blue dog, a blue pit bull. I seen black and tans. Gary Hammons had the black and tan, some black and tans, but not once did I ever see a blue dog. I don't think that they were. I don't think the real game bred pit bulls came in that color. I think the color comes from putting something outside blood into them. I think a lot of people think it comes from the Neapolitan Mastiffs, you know, when they created these big, heavy set, muscular dogs that aren't 100% pit bull. You know, like that Hulk dog and stuff.
Right.
Yeah, so no, I never saw a blue, and as long as I was in the dogs and as many different dog yards that I went to, I think if there was any blues around, I would have spotted them at least one time. So I'd have to say no, there weren't any really game bred pit bulls that were 100% pure. Game bred pit bulls that had the blue color.
Right.
Maybe, you know, I can't say that for sure, because I mean, I wasn't in every single yard, and Lee and me were talking about it, and some old pedigrees, this guy's were calling the dogs blue, and the guy was a game dog breeder, so maybe occasionally there was a few blues. I can't say that there wasn't, or some kind of little color that was off. And they had those dogs they called the Blue Paul. So maybe a few of them. There might have been a few blues around. I couldn't say for sure. Maybe a color that was sort of, they didn't know how to describe it, so they just called it blue.
Okay.
But I never saw one. Not once.
Now, in your experience, have you seen American Pit Bull Terriers be used for personal protection?
Well, I, I was never into that. Most of them, it depends on the dog. Most of them aren't very good at it because most of them are real friendly, but some of them aren't. Some of them are, this one guy, I didn't think it was very funny. He had this pit bull, and she was mean as hell, and he'd let her run around loose, you know, and I'd be, you know, people have to make sure she didn't bite him. She was pretty damn mean, and I had some to just flat hated strangers. I had not very many. The you know, 95-98% of my dogs, just loved people, but I had some dogs, and they're real good dogs, you know, they're real good dogs, but they, it all come from this one bitch, her name was Amber Gal, and she didn't like any strangers, and all the pups off her were the same way. They just, they didn't like anybody that they weren't familiar with, and they would go after them, you know. I'd have to warn people, stay away from that dog, don't stick your fingers in the fence or anything, because, they don't like strangers at all. So, but normally, most of the pit bulls, you know, they when they bred the breed, they had to make them fairly friendly because they have to handle them in the pit. And if they were man biters, who the hell would jump in the pit with a man biter? And so they were bred to not really go after people. But there's exceptions, you know. There's dogs that that would guard them, and Lee he crosses his, and his dogs are tremendous guard dogs. So and I guess some of his original pit bulls too are that way, you know. I don't know exactly how he does it, but he crosses the pit bulls. You know, he picks them out, the mastiffs and the pit bulls, and he and his dogs are natural guard dogs. In general, I'd say pit bulls really aren't a very good, but they could probably be trained to be. You know, they could probably be trained to be. They're a little on the small side.
Yeah.
You know, Lee's dogs are much more intimidating because they're twice the size of a pit bull. But yeah, a pit bull could do protection work. You know, they could probably be trained that way. You know, because pit bulls are eager to please, and if somebody geared their dog up to attack people, they could probably be effective.
Right.
As a guard dog.
Do you believe a game-bred pit bull as a puppy can be brought into a house with other dogs, raised with other dogs, and ultimately get along with the other dogs?
Well, I've had people say they could do it, so it probably could be done. It's sort of an uphill battle, you know. I mean, you're going against the dog's nature because... they might get along for a while, but as soon as something pisses them off, then they're not going to take that, you know. And then some, it would depend on the pit bull, you know, but some of them are just so ferocious that it couldn't be done. I had one little puppy, her name was I named her Cheryl Teagues, and she, from the time she was about 4 weeks old, if she laid eyes on another dog, she would attack it as hard as she possibly could. And she was just a little baby, sort of 3 or 4 weeks old, and she was that way even at that age. I mean, there was no hesitation. As soon as she saw another puppy, she'd just jump on it. So a bitch like that could never be trained to get along. Maybe another one with a little more mellow personality might be, but some of them are just too intense. Or Bolio, for instance, you could never make Bolio get along with other dogs. He wants to kill them too much. So it would depend on the dog. It would depend on the dog a lot. Now, some pit bulls, it could be done. Other pit bulls, I'd say it's pretty much impossible. You know, they just have too much natural fighting instincts to ask them to get along with other dogs. Mm-hmm. I had some dogs that, you know, if they got loose out of the pen, they as soon, you know, I had my dogs in runs because they had the chain laws. You couldn't have them on chains. And if they got away from me and got loose out of the pen, then they were gone. They were looking for a fight immediately. And these were dogs that hadn't been schooled or anything. They just, that's just the way they were.